playing Abraham Video.
Go.
You see, we understand how the contrast of life has caused you to identify the specifics of who you are and what you want, where you want to be, how you want to feel, how you want to live. All of that is known. And our attention, the attention of your inner being, the attention of all that is non-physical, the attention, if you will, of something that you say all the time and you don't even know what it means. Powers that be, the energy that creates worlds, the attention, this benevolent, loving energy, force, supporting you, uplifting you, knowing you, and most of all, knowing right where you stand, right here, right now, in relationship to who you have become. So you came into this body that all of you didn't come, a part of the consciousness, the consciousness that is you. A part of the consciousness that is you, focused here in this physical body, but the larger part of the consciousness that is you, remains non-physically focused in that stable, non-resistant place. So when life causes you to know what you don't want, which causes you to launch a rocket of desire about what you do want, the larger part of you is in on all of that. In other words, in this deciphering of who you are and where you are going process, Source is in on all of that. So you're launching these rockets and you are vibrationally becoming. And the reason that we want to point out that you are vibrationally becoming is because everything is a vibration before it is a manifestation. Everything is a vibration before it can be interpreted through your physical senses. And there are lots of ways.
You hear that? She said everything is a vibration before it can be manifested.
You interpret vibration through your physical senses. What you're seeing and hearing and smelling and tasting and touching, all of that is vibrational interpretation. You're just really good at it, so good you don't even realize that you're doing it. But everything, hear this, everything about the reality that you know as your reality, everything that you are seeing in this world and living in this world, you and everyone else around you, every bit of it is a realization.
Swoffin. How's a little friend? Hey, feeling good. Are you farty? Yeah, put me a farty. Ooh, you're yucky.
Split energy, wanting it and doubting it at the same time. Let's pause it right there. Wanting it and doubting it at the same time. That would be like being lost in the rapids of thought. Because that's the rapid, those are the thoughts of doubt and unbelief, the rapids. And how we bring ourselves out of the rapids is we focus on the vibration of the present moment, which is the walls around us, or if we're outside, Mother Nature. That's what you call 1 foot on the land and 1 foot on the water. 1 foot on the water is your thoughts and the ego, which is the doubt and the sin and the unbelief. One foot on the land is grounded on everything that is the land, which is all the stuff that's around us. 1 foot on the water, 1 foot on the ground. That's something for you to think about and add to your learning. Meditate on that and let the universe show you and make that known to you what that means. Alright, here we go. Some more Abraham. Yeah.
Yes. We want you to find the feeling place of what you want, which means you got to find some way of conjuring it. But if you just stop beating the drum of not having it, that will be enough. You don't have to proclaim things you don't have. It's hard on you in your society. But it would be helpful if you would stop pointing out sometimes don't allow yourself to see it. You not responsible for what other people do, and other people do a lot of really dumb things. There are other people doing things out there that if you all took a vote, most of you would vote, they shouldn't ought to kind of sort of be doing that. They have not been doing that. In other words, we get it that there are people doing things that you don't like, and we're not saying that you should like them. But we are saying you must stop making those conditions over which you have no control be such a big part of your attention, because your attention to what you do not want puts you in a resistant state and keeps you, and this is the operative word, out of the receptive mode. And if you're out of the receptive mode, then it doesn't...
So, Abraham just said, if you keep your attention on those things that you don't want, that keeps you from the receptive mode of the things that you do want.
It doesn't matter how many clues we're given.
Hey, go over there.
Go this way. Go over there. You'll like what you find. Tell me what it is or I won't go. That's how you act. Okay, I'll play your silly. I'll pay the price of happiness if I have to. So, what we want you to accept, and words don't teach, only life experience gives you understanding. What we want you to accept is that you live in a...
She just said, words don't teach, only life's experience gives you understanding.
...vibrational universe, and that the powerful law of attraction manages all of the vibrations, and that you are a focusing mechanism, and therefore you are a vibrational being, and therefore you are offering a steady vibrational frequency, and the universe is responding to the frequency that you are offering. So there are two ways that you can tell what...
So... The universe responds to the frequencies that we offer. So if we think about what it feels like to have that ATM card and direct to the trust account, then that will manifest. That's the frequency that we put out, then the universe will automatically, through the law of agreement, or the law of attraction, manifested in our life. The more we can focus on that frequency, the sooner it will enter, manifest in our life. So Abraham said, don't sit around figuring out what you're doing wrong, because that just attracts all the wrong to you. The more you dwell upon it, the more you enter into that vibration, then the universe will manifest that attraction to you, and you'll just have a bunch of problems all the time magnating into your life, into our life. So she says, focus on that which we want.
Yourself to the frequency of who you really are, little by little. And we want to say to you, let yourself off the hook, because law of attraction is not going to let you get very far from how you feel. Because how you feel is as a result of what you've been offering. And there is momentum already underway. You know about momentum, don't you?
So Abraham said, how you feel, or your vibration, how you feel is what you're offering. So if you feel insecure, then we're offering a vibration of insecurity. Let the spirit reveal that to the mind. Now she's going to talk about momentum. She said, in the same way that you initiate momentum for the things that you don't want, you can take that momentum and turn it around to the things that you do want. In other words, the momentum is the feeling of being in balance with your thoughts and that which is around you that keeps you grounded. The more you focus on being alive, which is the things that are around you, in balance with your thoughts. So you might spend a couple minutes in thought and then come to yourself and say, oh, well, I need to ground. A few minutes in thought, you need to ground for a few minutes. So you're taking a step, a left foot, a right foot. You're thinking. You might be in the rushing rapids of thought. Now you bring yourself and you ground yourself for a couple minutes. And you step like that. Boom, boom. And you can even do it moment by moment. You're in the rushing rapids of thought. That's your contrast. So you instantly remind yourself, oh yeah, let me be right here in the present moment. Because that is where I manifest everything, is the vibration that I'm sending out right now. So in order to get in touch with that vibration, I have to sit here and focus on the body. And the body is Mother Nature. And Mother Nature is all these walls that are around here, including my body. And it's everything outside in nature. Ooh, that was a good one.
Source energy in physical bodies. And you have a strong momentum of well-being going before you came into these physical bodies. That's a powerful
point.
That momentum will carry you on into the future. That's the vibration that is really who you are, is the vibration of well-being. And you can tap into it.
And she said, when you tap into that vibration and you maintain it and you keep the momentum going, that's what brings you into the state of eternity. And I have felt that before, what it feels like to be in that state of eternity. It's quite an awesome feeling. So, it all comes down to feeling good, manifesting a vibration of just feeling good. So, if feeling good is actually just sitting here and doing nothing, that makes me feel good, I'm going to keep that vibration going. See? Now, if I do something to interrupt my good feeling vibration, like eat a whole quart of ice cream in one setting, I might not feel very good, and so my vibration is interrupted. So now you know the advantage to modesty in the things that we participate in throughout the day. Think about that to help you help us keep maintain a vibration of feeling good. She's talking about yogi observations. If you just sit around and observe everything, then that's what you're going to manifest. It's just a life full of observation. And this is the message of some of the yogis, especially Muji that I listen to. he says, just separate yourself and just observe everything. Separate yourself, just observe. So now you're just creating a vibration of observation, and your life will be nothing but a bunch of observation. And true prosperity will never attract to you until such a time as you learn how to focus on what it feels like to be prosperous. Think about that. Yogi observations at 13. I put that in the record.
Buddy.
We love you so much, but it seems so odd to us with all of the obvious signs that you do not see them.
See the woods?
Because you're not in the receptive mode.
Feel the goods.
You're amplifying questions rather than expecting answers. And of course, you're not doing this all the time. In your world that is working.
Hold a friend.
Focusing on keeping a good vibration with your animals and your cats is of necessity also. Because if you're petting your cats or if you're brushing your cats and it's causing them to get mad, then that's ruining the vibration of the atmosphere. So it's best just to stop as soon as there's any sign of resistance from the cat. Just stop combing the cat. Stop touching the cat. If you sense that the cat's tail is waggering and swishing, that means stop instantly. So that the cat can feel good also. Alright, so that was the end of that Abraham message.